All right, good afternoon here from Bobcat Field on the west campus of Georgia College. It's a beautiful, what is today? Tuesday? Wednesday? Monday? Saturday. On a good Saturday afternoon here at Georgia College. I'm Riley Williams alongside David Paulson here with a nice matchup between the Georgia College Bobcats and the Clayton State Lakers. Now, David, why don't you introduce the starting lineups for us today?
Okay, so for Clayton State, you have Jessica Sharman at goalkeeper. We have Yane Brower at defender, Jasmine Mietinen, defender, Manoli Bacarizo at defender, Alexis Gibson at defender, and in the midfield, Erica Guernsey, Claudia Granja, Maria Marti Bartis, and Tovin Saleh, and then up front, we have Aina Tapio. And then for our Bobcats, we have Ashley Graham starting in goal, and we have Elise Schwartz, Emily Wilhelm, Millie York, and Sarah Miller in defense. We have Amanda Ferry, Casey Hamilton, Raggi, she's a forward, Sol Baldessini in midfield, and then up top we have Sophia Lekas and Raggi Bjarnadottir.
All right, well, looking forward to a nice matchup today. Clayton State comes into this game 4-2 overall record. They're 1-1 in the Peach Belt, and Georgia College comes into this game at 3-1-1 and also 1-1 in the Peach Belt. Looks like Clayton State will start off with the ball. We have the Bobcats going from right to left on your screen and Clayton State going from left to right. This will be the third game of Peach Belt Conference play for both of these teams. Ashley Graham this is her second start back from an injury in week two. And we're off.
The Bobcats are coming off a 4-0 victory over USC Aiken in their last game on Wednesday. And Clayton State is actually coming off a 3-0 defeat to UNC Pembroke. So definitely two different results for the teams here.
We got Clayton State out of bounds. It'll be a Bobcat throw in. Schwartz will look upfield. Throws it in over Raggy's head. Schwartz with a pass into the middle to Ferry. Back out Baldessini. Looking left, out here to Miller on the back. Back to Baldessini, back to Miller. Dispossessed. It'll be a Georgia College throw in here. Miller with the throw. Into the middle. Dispossessed. Clayton State has it. Moving up in the middle of the field. Up to out wide to Fletcher. She looks in to play it to the middle. Fletcher still with the ball. Cleared out by Baldessini. Lekas playing some defense here.
It's a nice tackle.
Nice tackle. Plays it up to Raggi. Raggi with possession. With a pass to Maddie Steven, who is dispossessed, cleared out by the Clayton State defense.
Just not enough support there for the Bobcats.
Yeah, we're looking at a lot of defensive play here in the first 2 minutes of action. David, it's hot.
It is hot.
It is very hot.
I can
hot.
Only imagine with us sitting here in the stands how hot it must be on the field.
Out wide to Miller. With a shot on goal, saved by Clayton State's keeper, Jessica Charman, as she tells her team to get upfield. It's a nice shot there by Miller. She was wide open on the left side. Punted upfield, headed away. Out of bounds will be a Clayton State throw-in.
It's always good to see how the keeper will react in the first few minutes of the game. always nice to at least make them work.
Yeah, exactly. You got to kind of scare them back there.
Yeah.
Steven pressuring the Clayton back line, Clayton State back line. The George College throw in Schwartz right at midfield. Throw it into Lekas in the middle. Giving it up straight to the Clayton State midfield. But one back, played back to the keeper, Ashley Graham, with her first touch of the game.
It's a nice touch.
Yeah.
Some good hold-up play there.
Yeah, Manferry out wide to Schwartz. Schwartz playing it up to Steven. Just is not able to get there. Some physical play early on here. Fletcher out wide for Clayton State to number three, Guernsey. Taken away by Wilhelm. Played back to York. Out wide to Miller. And sent upfield. Out wide to number 13, Sayla. Looking upfield, trying to figure out what she's going to do with it. She plays it in. Cleared out by York. York has been solid all year defending for the Bobcats. She's kind of led that back line into not many goals scored against the Bobcats. With a shot by number four, Yane Brower. Stopped by Graham.
And the Bobcats have only allowed 3 goals all year, and that was in their 3-1 loss to number 12, North Georgia. So they were playing a pretty decent team. But other than that, clean sheets.
And not only has it just been Graham, but Catapano came in there for a couple of games and played really well. She was actually Defensive Player of the Week, I'm pretty sure.
Hmm.
For 1 week. It was like 2 weeks ago, but yeah.
Oh, this is dangerous play.
This is dangerous play. Graham. Oh,
wow.
What a goal. What a goal by number 10, Maria Marti Bartis.
And she was the player to watch coming in for Clayton State. By far leading the Lakers in shots on goal, shots. And now this is her 3rd goal of the season.
Yeah, she had 31 shots. Which is unbelievable, just for 6 games. So,
but
the Bobcats are down 1-0 now.
And now she has 32 shots.
32 shots and 3 goals.
So definitely not what we wanted to see from the Bobcats early on. Just a defensive breakdown there, and Bart is showing a lot of pace there as well.
A lot of pace, just flew by. Played back to Raggy as the game gets going, but. Back here, Wilhelm, back to Baldassini. Played up. There goes Maddie Steven on a breakaway. She's with
That's
footwork.
Nice footwork.
Shot. Score.
Hey.
Goal by Maddie Steven.
Wow. Right into the bottom corner.
Wow. What a response. What a response to that goal scored by Clayton State. Maddie Steven with a great goal into the bottom left corner.
That's an individual effort right there. She dribbled past the defender and then slotted it right into the bottom left-hand corner. What a response, especially about a minute and a half.
Yeah. That was a great ball by Baldassini as well, just right over that back line. As you can hear the Bobcat fans here getting ready for this interesting game. Played out wide to Steven again. Oh. Maybe it could have been a foul there, but ref says play on. Played into the middle, headed away by York.
It's a nice head down.
Played back out to the right side to York. Into the middle to Hamilton, back out to York. The Bobcats have the momentum right now. But Clayton State is not wavering. They are playing pretty solid defense here right after that goal.
It's been pretty up and down so far.
Yeah.
A lot of quick movement. Not a whole lot of slow build-up play like we often see.
Yep.
Looks like both teams are ready to go out there and and score some goals tonight, or this afternoon.
Played up the ball to Sini. Another ball into the middle, headed away by Clayton State's back line. Played out wide to Guernsey. Into the middle. Taken away by Baldassini. Played back to Ashley Graham. She will clear that out of the field. It'll be a Clayton State throw in. Number three, Burnsy, will toss it in here for Clayton State. Right into Fletcher. Leads to another throw in. And yet another throw-in.
Clayton State with some consistent pressure here. They're going to need to get it into the middle, though.
Fletcher with an unfortunate touch that will lead to a goal kick for the Bobcats. Ashley Graham backs way up for this kick. Sends it right to midfield.
Ooh.
Over to Bacquerizo. Is that right?
Bacquerizo.
This Clayton State front line has a lot of speed. They are torching this Bobcat back line right now. I wonder how they will respond to that.
Just need to make sure they don't press too far forward, because on that goal they conceded from Bartis, they were kind of taken aback. It was a nice counterattack, and Bartis just dribbled right through.
Yeah.
That could have been a handball on Lekas, but none called.
Fletcher taken away.
That was Sol Baldassini with a nice interception there.
Fletcher again in the middle, taken away by Raggy. Raggy looking upfield to figure out what she's going to do with it. Plays it up. Intercepted. Raggy back with possession, back to Miller. Miller made her miss there. Out wide to Lekas. Into Steven. Out wide to Raggy with a heavy touch there.
Still some nice build-up play by the Bobcats.
Yeah.
Some nice skill by Miller. She's been one of the Bobcats' better players so far. Nice shot on goal in the first couple minutes.
Yeah. We got a Clayton State player down here. Got the trainer coming out. It'll be a foul called on Georgia College. Cannot see the number of who that is. A little break in the action here. There are a lot of Peach Belt Conference games going on today. We got Armstrong State at Young Harris, USC Aiken at Southwestern, Columbus State at UNC Pembroke, and of course Georgia College and Clayton State, North Georgia at Francis Marion, and Flagler at Montevallo. So today is a busy day for the Peach Belt. So if you want to keep up with all those, be sure to follow Peach Belt Conference on Twitter and Instagram to keep updated with those. And this is probably a much-needed water break here for the ladies, as number 15, Manoli Bacquerizo, gets up. She seems to be walking off all right.
Yeah, it's definitely been a hot day out there, and I've seen players on both teams not necessarily running at full speed, trying to conserve their energy for all 90 minutes. So Bacquerizo will stay on the sidelines and
with a Lakers free kick here. waiting for the ref to signal. It's a short one.
And Bacariza is back on the pitch.
Maddie Steven with some solid defense there.
Almost nutmegged by...
Almost.
But she wasn't going to let that happen.
Up to Lekas.
Oh.
Somehow she retained that. Up forward to Raggy. Cleared away by Charman. York again with solid defense in the back. Out wide to Miller. As she looks to get past Fletcher here. Fletcher will knock it out of bounds for a Bobcat throw-in.
Miller has not been shy about taking on Fletcher there on the left side.
Not at all.
This whole game.
Up to Steven. Steven's wide right. She looks to cross it here. Into the middle. Ooh. Right past Lekas. Here goes Baldassini.
Some nice speed by Baldassini
there. Yeah, a low cross. Cleared out by the Clayton State back line. Back to Miller, into the middle to Hamilton. Now, as she plays it forward to Steven.
That's a nice ball.
Interrupted back there by, goodness, by Bacarizo, leading to a Bobcat throw-in. Thrown into Amanda Ferry, just squeezed by her. Picked up by Charman. As she yells at her players to get back and press forward. Raggy with possession. A nice ball to Lekas.
Offside.
Who,
That looked like a nice move as well.
Can't hurt to be aggressive every once in a while, but it just didn't work out that time. It'll be a Clayton State free kick. Right up to the middle. Bobcats will let it go through to Graham. She picks it up. High kick. Right of midfield. Bardis in midfield.
A lot of space.
Played through, we'll go out for a goal kick. Like we said earlier, David, that Clayton State midfield and front line have a lot of pace, so that will be interesting to see how, if they can keep it up for the rest of the game, or if it will run out before this first half gets over with.
Yeah, they're very aggressive, especially in the midfield. Bardis, who scored earlier, their top goal scorer from the midfield, and she's, like we said, taken more shots than pretty much the whole team combined. So midfield definitely more attacking.
Yeah. As York fumbles with it, Graham comes out and clears it. Ooh, with an unlucky offsides call there. It was like playing FIFA. Immediately taking. Free kick is Clayton State, played back to their back line. Played forward up to number 9, Claudia. You say that last name. I'm sorry.
Grana.
Claudia Grana.
Oh, that's some nice skill there.
Yeah. Played back into the middle to immediately headed out by York. Schwartz. On the ball here. Hamilton plays up to Steven, who just does not have the juice to get there at the moment. Played back up, immediately headed out by York.
A lot of long balls, a lot of fast play by both teams. Again, nice footwork by Miller.
Miller's been on top of her game here on the left side. Played out to Ferry. Dispossessed by Fletcher, but she gets it back to Lekas. Lekas dispossessed. Miller with the ball. Play to Lekas again. Lekas frustrated with that kick. Now out wide with Clayton State making a counterattack here.
And this is where they're dangerous, as they've already shown.
That speed. Bardis plays it in. Schwartz with a nice defense, cleared out.
That's a foul. That's on Bacarizo.
Looks like, oh, Milliort, quick free kick. Out to Steven. Cleared out by number 13, Sela. Schwartz with a throw in for the Bobcats. Just under 30 minutes left to go here in the first half of play. Baldassini in the middle.
There she is.
Miller making a run, but couldn't find her on the left side.
Time.
Baldassini again with the ball. Players calling for a run. Lekas will get there. Will she score?
Oh.
Wide left. That was a great ball in by Baldassini.
Just now, miscontrolled.
Yeah. Now cleared out. Headed back in by Baldassini. Into number 18, Ayana Tapio. Fletcher out wide. Kind of a pointless pass in the middle there. Played back by Schwartz to Graham as she scans the field. And sends it downfield.
Almost too good of a kick there. No one could get there.
Ooh, it'll roll out for Bobcat, though, and some nice field placement there for the Bobcats. As Schwartz looks to throw it in.
Well, ever since that flurry the first few minutes, not a whole lot of shots on goal. Definitely a lot of play going up and down, but not a whole lot of shots here.
Yeah, there's only Clayton State only has two shots. George College has one. So, oh, we have a sub here. Well, not yet. The buzzer rang, but that will allow play to go on. Schwartz plays it in to Raggy. Raggy with a miss hit there.
Blocked again by the defense.
It'll be another Bobcat throw in. Schwartz will toss it in for George College. Goes straight into Ferry. Cleared out. York there. Millie still with it. Millie York.
Nice tackle.
Yeah, play ball.
She's still going.
Have yourself a day, Millie York. She's getting tired there as Clayton State takes up the sidelines out for a George College throw-in. Schwartz is busy over there on the side throwing it in today. And it's only been about 20 minutes.
And the sun's back out after we had a nice little bit of cloud cover from the beginning of the game. But
yeah,
it's not going to make it any easier on players down there.
Thrown into Raggy. Headed it almost over the fence. Now a substitution in for Clayton State.
Looks to be...
number is that?
Alexis Gibson coming out.
And number 7, Jane...
McKevitt,
yeah. Coming in for Clayton State.
Sure, we'll see a lot more substitutions as the first half
progresses. Clayton State on the attack here. McKevitt's still on the ball. It'll go out for a Clayton State throw in.
And you can just see the energy, fresh legs out there.
Yeah.
For the Lakers.
Another throw in for the Lakers.
It's a nice turn.
Played out by Hamilton. Clayton State's had Georgia College backed up on their hind legs here the past 2 minutes, trying to get themselves a goal. That cross was tipped by Schwartz. It will be the first corner of the game for either team. As Clayton State struggles to figure out who's going to take the corner. Doesn't look like anybody's over there. There goes Bardis over there to take the corner. We have two Bobcats backed up on each post of the goal as Clayton State crowds the top of the box. Hand in the air, corner away. Headed out.
Oh, wow.
Headed out by Steven.
Almost an own goal there.
Ball is bouncing around. Raggy. Whew. It's close there. Wow. Two Bobcat players are flying in to knock that one out of there. Played immediately back in by Guernsey, where Grana cannot get to that, so it will be a goal kick for Graham.
And that's going to be a big sigh of relief for the Bobcats, especially the goalie, Ashley Graham, seeing the ball headed by one of the defenders. And luckily, we had a Bobcat on the line to clear that. That could have been a real momentum killer for the Bobcats if that had gone in.
Yeah. Luckily, Maddie Steven was there. Out wide is Clayton State. Played in. Graham is right there for the stop. There's yet to be a change for the Bobcats, player-wise. I wonder if we'll see any changes soon. But for now, played into the middle. It's Clayton State. It's number 18, Ayana Tapio, with some footwork there. Out wide to Fletcher. Fletcher crosses, blocked by Miller, and cleared out by Wilhelm.
It looks like we will have a couple of Georgia College substitutions in a minute. Looks like Boone.
Somebody else. I don't know.
Boone Omar starts here, and we'll let you know when they come on.
Yeah.
Next stoppage of play.
It is another corner for Clayton State as Tapio comes over to take it. Again, two players for the Bobcats on either post.
And that strategy worked very well
last
time.
Saved us. As Clayton State crowds the top of the box. Kick away high. Headed out by York. Lekas on the ball. That will be a Georgia College throw in as the substitutions come on. Out goes Steven and Lekas.
And that's Amanda Bartholomew and Unbjork Omasdottir coming in for the Bobcats.
Schwartz with a throw in here for the Bobcats. Another throw in. Schwartz has thrown the ball in about 48 times today. It's a lot.
It is a lot.
Just under 22 minutes here left to go in the first half. As Tapio for Clayton State plays it center for number 7, Jane McKevitt, out wide to Fletcher for Clayton State. Fletcher takes a shot. Graham is right there. No problem for her. Graham immediately throws it out wide to Miller as Miller takes a speed move wide right up the sideline, now into the middle.
Fletcher just can't contain her on that left side.
Oh, Miller's been on top of her game today. Clayton State has it on their back line right now, looking to switch the play as they bring it up into the midfield area. out wide to Bartis. And Bartis taking off right into the middle. It's right to Ashley Graham.
Last dish defending there by York.
Grana, just her size and athletic ability has enabled her to get past some of those Bobcat defenders today and almost led to a goal right there. It's a throw in for Clayton State. Play back to Bartis. Into the center over the referee who ducked right there. Number 7, McKevitt, out wide. Guarded by Schwartz. Schwartz with a nice tackle. No call. Another nice tackle by Schwartz. Out of bounds. It will be a Clayton State throw-in. Oh, I take that back. A Georgia College throw-in. Up to Uno. Taken away by McKevitt. Out goes number 11, Fletcher. And in comes number 12, Ikyar Duran.
Interesting fact here, we have 10 different countries represented in this game. We have, of course, the United States, but we also have England, Trinidad, Iceland, Denmark, Finland, Ireland, Spain, Sweden, and Ecuador.
Wow.
So that is definitely shows how these two programs are stepping outside of the U.S. borders and recruiting from all over the world.
Yeah, that's actually really cool.
the Bobcats have Renee Mike from Trinidad. They have, of course, Raggy and Un from Iceland, and Millie York, one of the Bobcat star players in this game from England.
Yeah.
So definitely pretty cool to have all those nations represented here.
Yeah. As Graham looks for this goal kick to go right to midfield to Hamilton, guarded by Bartis. Played up in the air by McKevitt to Tapia. Flicked forward by Ferry. Played out of bounds. Will be a Bobcat throw in on the right side. Schwartz again with a throw in.
I think her arms are getting as much work in as her legs.
Yeah.
Oh. Collision with Un there, but she holds her ground.
Those Icelandic girls, they're tough.
They are.
Bartholomew up top. A little rough play there by Casey Hamilton. Quick free kick, though, by Clayton State.
That is the tone of this game.
Yeah. Clayton State plays it to the middle. Millie York clears it out. Lets the Bobcats reset back there.
Again, they just have a lot of speed over there with Bacarizo from Ecuador and Bartis, of course, the goal scorer.
Just under 17 minutes left to go here in the first half. The score is 1-1. It's been a pretty evenly matched game here today. A few subs for each side in right now. And it's just mainly been back and forth if you're just joining us.
Not a lot of shots, but definitely a lot of action.
Exactly. As well put. Well put. There's another throw in for the Bobcats. Up to Un. Headed, flicked back. Into the middle. To Grana, who overpowers York. Just her. Oh. As the offsides is called, but the ref loses his flag. That was pretty good. You don't see that a lot. Graham takes it out to York for the free kick. York plays it to Un. Un out to Schwartz. Schwartz dispossessed but regained it. Physical play there by the ladies up top.
As Grana.
Yeah, Grana takes off down side, played back into the middle to McKevitt. McKevitt gains possession, but the pass was too hard, and it will go out of bounds.
Anya Montanelli in for your Bobcats. Out goes Raggy.
Yeah, Renee!
And Renee Gillespie in for the Clayton State Lakers.
It'll be a Clayton State throw in.
We've mentioned Granha a lot. She's by far the tallest player on the pitch today at 5'11".
Mm.
And the next tallest is 5'9", Amanda Ferry. So definitely a big height advantage for the Lakers.
Out wide. Duran doing some work. Dispossessed by Baldassini. And she was grabbed by McKevitt there. It'll be a free kick. Baldassini.
Maybe a bit of a frustration foul there.
Yeah.
Wasn't too happy about getting dribbled by.
Baldassini plays it up. Gets over the back line, but just out of the reach of Bartholomew as Charmin is signaling her players to go to the left side of the pitch. High punt into the midfield. Headed forward. As Bartis takes control of the ball. Oh, that's not Bartis. I'm sorry. That is Gillespie. Oh, what a nice save there by Graham. It was point blank, went wide right. That'll be another corner for Clayton State as number 12, Duran, will take it. That was just some miscommunication there by the back line. You can see some of the ladies rolling their sleeves up as the kick goes in. It's high on the back post. Will be another corner as one of the Bobcats got a piece of it.
Ashley Graham directing traffic back there.
Gave Duran a little nudge there as she ran by.
We have seen a decent amount of fouls in this game so far.
Yeah, it's physical. It's conference play. Peach Belt, baby. High cross. Punched out by Graham. It's a cluster of folks in there. There's a shot. Stopped by Graham. Graham rolls it out to Millie York. As York plays it up to Bartholomew.
Back to York.
Yeah, back to York. Plays it back to Wilhelm in the middle of the field as she's all alone. And way out here to the left to Sarah Miller. Plays up for to Un. In the middle, Bartis out wide to number 6, Gillespie. As she takes it in the middle now to Duran.
Sarah Miller again with a nice play there.
Yeah. Sarah Miller sends it. Doesn't look like Bartholomew will get there. Again, scooped up by Charmin, who throws it in to number 3, Guernsey, for Clayton State. With an unfortunate touch there. Mancinelli out wide. Oh. One more pass. That might have been a goal there for the Bobcats. Sarah Miller here with the defense on Duran for Clayton State. she gets dispossessed. Back to Guernsey. As Clayton State looks to play it upfield. Back to Guernsey. With some footwork. Back to Duran. Into the middle to Grana. Grana plays it way back to the back line. Outside to Sayla. And it will be a Clayton State throw-in. Number 15, Bacquarizo, tosses it into Sayla, who is immediately hounded by Schwartz. There's a foul on Clayton State. Looks like Un was hit from behind as she was trying to gain possession of that ball. York takes the free kick. Short one to Baldassini. Baldassini taking it up the field. Right over the back line. Just again, a little bit too hard. Straight to the keeper, to Charman. Just under 10 minutes here left in the first half. Clayton State and Georgia College are tied at 0-0. Not 0-0. What am I doing? Soccer. Goodness. 1-1. Wilhelm up top. Taken away by Baldassini. Back up to Duran on the side. As she plays it in, York is there yet again and clears out that cross. McKevitt over to Bardis. Bardis rips it, but the field goal is good, and that ball will go into the trees.
Raleigh Animachon on here, and that is Un going off.
Graham for the goal kick. York with possession. Playing it up to Mancinelli. Out wide, just out of the reach of Bartholomew. Leading to another Clayton State throw-in. The action today has definitely been on the far side of the field. There has not been a lot of up and down play here on this front side, closest to the stands.
And when there has been, it's been Sarah Miller.
Yeah. Yeah, Sarah Miller has definitely been a big part of this left side of play for the Bobcats. Got Bardis in the middle controlling the game right now. Out wide to Duran. It's Duran with some footwork. Guarded by Miller. Sent in by McKevitt. Just over the head of Bacquazzaro. It will be another goal kick for Graham. As Graham sends it away. Graham waving off York there. Punted away to midfield. Right up to Ferry, but taken away. Baldassini out wide to Miller. Here goes that Sarah Miller that we've been talking about all day on the left side. Touch there by Duran. That will be a Bobcat throw-in. A little confusion here. That will be a free kick for Clayton State. An unfortunate foul on Bartholomew.
I think it was going to be a Georgia College throw-in. Deflected off of Ithiar Duran, but unfortunately that foul negates that.
Baldassini back to York. Out to Miller again. Miller to Ferry in the middle. Ferry with some nice footwork. Almost got through to Animashon. Now Mancinelli. Oh, Animashon called offsides.
Inches there.
Yeah. Just at 5 minutes left to go here in the first half. Duran moving up the field for Clayton State. Out wide. Oh, heavy touch there by Gillespie. It will be a goal kick for Georgia College.
Just under 5 minutes to go here. Clayton State leading the shot count. The shot tally 8-3, but I would say it's been pretty even so far.
Yeah.
In the general flow of the game.
Wilhelm will clear that out up to Bartholomew. As Bartholomew is hounded with two Clayton State defenders, and she does not know where that ball just went. Out wide to number three, Guernsey. Played center. Graham will beat it out. Quickly out. Quickly played out to York on the right side. Into the middle to Mancinelli. Played back to Casey Hamilton, who looks right in the middle for Bartholomew, but she could not get there for that one. Played out wide to Amishon. Emishon plays in the middle to Bartholomew, cleared out by the Clayton State back line. Georgia College holding possession here pretty well. Out wide to Miller from Baldassini. Still with possession now is Ferry. Back to Baldassini. Baldassini looking left to Miller with a slide tackle there by Clayton State. Number three, Guernsey. Bartholomew tackles it, and it will go out for a Clayton State throw-in. Right at 3 minutes here, left in the first half. With Bartholomew to Amishon.
Nice control.
Amishon back to Mancinelli. Nobody out wide to the right, so Mancinelli has to take it up the middle herself. To the right to Duran. As number nine, Grana, questions that ball as it gets to Graham. Miller out wide to Bartholomew. Immediately dispossessed. As you can hear the Georgia College fan base here questioning that call. Played back to Graham. Just at 2 minutes left. Graham taking her time, milking the clock down. Ladies want to get to halftime.
I think as the game has gone on, it's gotten a little more physical and a little less pacey.
Exactly.
Clayton State not looking as threatening on the counterattack.
That pace that we talked about earlier is definitely declined. So it'll be a Bobcat throw-in. Miller looking forward to Bartholomew. With a questionable call there by the referee, but hey, it's soccer. It'll be a Clayton State throw-in. Right at a minute 15 left in the half. Played forward. But York is there. York forward to Hamilton. Hamilton out wide to Amishon, but taken away. Back to Mancinelli. Mancinelli plays it. Now Miller. As we are reaching 49 seconds left in the game. Ball gets over. Amishon, will she get there? No, she will not. Oh,
that was a nice last chance for the Bobcats there.
Yeah.
Before halftime. Again, just inches away.
As Charmin takes it back up to for this goal kick with about 20 seconds left in the half. Clayton State, Georgia College here tied 1-1. 10 seconds now. The ladies are in no rush here for this ball to get back in. And that is halftime, ladies and gentlemen. I am Riley Williams here with David Paulson. Stay tuned for the second half of Clayton State and Georgia College as it is tied 1-1. Stay tuned. All right, and welcome back here to Bobcat Field on the West Campus of Georgia College for your second half action of your Georgia College Bobcats against Clayton State University. It is tied 1-1, and we got some first half stats for you. Why don't you let them know what those are here, David?
So we had Maria Marti Bartis, one of the probably the Clayton State's best player from the first half, scoring, assisted by Manoli Bacarizo, and then only a few seconds later, Maddie Stevens scored her second of the season, assisted by Sol Baldassini, and that was a very nice goal, if you'll recall, into that bottom left-hand corner, and that was definitely a lot of action around each goal within a minute, but yeah. Other than that, not a whole lot of shots. Clayton State with 8 shots, Bobcats with 3. Ashley Graham has 3 saves. Jessica Sharman has none. But again, it's still 1-1 here, and hopefully we can see the Bobcats get at least one more in this half.
Yeah, well, we're looking forward to this second half of play here, with Ashley Graham hoping to continue her pretty decent play today, not allowing Bartis or maybe Grana to get back there and cap one in. Then hopefully we see Lekas or Raggy maybe get up there and get themselves a goal too. So a different starting lineup here for you, actually, in the second half without Raggy or Lekas starting up top. Instead, we have Steven and Michon. And also, is that Bartholomew over there? Like, right here? I don't know. I don't know. We'll see. We will see as the second half is about to get underway here at Bobcat Field. And here we go. And Michon turns back, plays it out wide to Schwartz as Clayton State pressuring hard here early. Throw into Casey Hamilton as Hamilton looks back to York. York to Baldassini. Baldassini looking way wide. It's Steven. Oh no. Is that Brooke Endress, the freshman out there on the top left of your screen? The freshman. Anna Michon with some fancy footwork there. Now, Steven getting around number 13. Sayla into the middle.
Just a bit too high.
Yeah. Headed out. Now, 15. Say that name one more time.
Bacarizo.
Bacarizo. Bacarizo. I gotta get that. Played out here. Now Schwartz with a throw. Schwartz looking for Steven. Intercepted by Bacarizo. Bartis plays the ball up top. Just squeaked over the head of Alexis Gibson into the hands of goalkeeper Ashley Graham. Graham with a sky-high punt. Some jersey grabbing there in the middle of the field with Ferry. Played out wide to number 19. Gibson cannot get to it. As the ref tells Schwartz to back up for the throw-in. Long throw in, trying to get to Animashon. Bartis plays back to Brower. Over to, how do you say that name?
Jasmine Miettinen.
Miettinen. Miettinen. Baldassini out wide on your left side. Played into Steven. It'll be a Bobcat throw in. The freshman, Brooke Endress, here with the throw in into Baldassini. Headed forward by Clayton State. Played out again. Duran with the throw in for Clayton State as Gibson tries to get to it but is not able to. Another throw in for Clayton State. Duran looking for number six, Gillespie. Gillespie plays back to McKevitt. Taken away, dispossessed. Right back into Clayton State. Possession, now Bobcats have it. Baldessini to Mancinelli, up to Anrashan, who is called off sides.
Close call there again. And one of the stars of the first half, Sarah Miller getting a rest here to begin the second half. The freshman, Brooke Indris, replacing her.
Yeah, well-deserved rest.
Definitely.
Well-deserved.
Millie York is back out there, one of the other top defenders for the Bobcats from the first half.
Booted away by Graham. In the middle, over Mancinelli. Over to Casey Hamilton. Out wide to Elise Schwartz. As Schwartz surveys the field, plays it in to Mancinelli, out wide to Anrashan, intercepted by number four, Brower, for Clayton State. Now up goes Bardis, streaking down the field, looking for a pass. Another offsides call on Clayton State.
Again, that pace. Let's come back after that halftime break. Bardis looking very dangerous going forward. Bobcats have to make sure they don't get too far forward in their own attack because that's where they got burned on their first goal and no offsides there and better run was made than could have been through.
Pressure by Steven as the ball goes out for the Georgia College throw-in. Brooke Indris will come up the field to make the throw as she is told to back it up a little bit. Emishon with possession with a shot deflected for the Bobcats' first corner of the game.
They'll take that.
They'll take that any day.
It's a bit fortunate there. That shot was not getting past Charmin.
Yeah.
But they'll definitely take the corner. Hopefully they can get something from this.
Yeah. As Baldessini lines up for the corner, or walks over there, we have Ferry, Mancinelli, York, everybody crowding the backside of the box. It's a low cross, easily taken care of by number 19, Alex Gibson, as she really tried to get it down there. Now another cross in for the Bobcats, headed out by number four, Brower, for Clayton State. Back out wide to Baldessini.
That was a nice header by Casey Hamilton.
Yeah. As Steven out wide again on your left side of the screen, as she tries to make a, oh, she makes a move. A high cross. Amanda Ferry is there, but will not get her head on it. As Clayton State will kick it out of bounds for a Georgia College throw-in. Schwartz here for the throw-in into Ferry. Schwartz crosses it in. The header.
Nice control.
Yeah. Ferry out wide, wide open. With a cross in, low cross. Almost an own goal.
What a save.
Almost.
Charmin.
Oh, wow. Charmin with a great save. With almost own goal there.
That was her first save of the game as well.
Wow.
So that's two almost own goals that we've seen. One from the Bobcats and one for the Lakers.
Yeah.
Took a header off of the line for the Bobcats earlier in the first half, and just there it took a great save from Charmin to keep the score 1-1.
Yeah. We have Indris here for the throw-in for the Bobcats. She throws it into Mancinelli. Mancinelli trying to get around. Clayton State defender. Yeah, with a foul on Clayton State. It'll be, looks to be Baldassini taking this free kick. Brooke Indris on your left, coming up the screen. Baldassini has a big left foot, looking to send it right into the top of the box there. A lot of movement around the 18. Kick is low, hard driven. Stopped by Bardis. Played out wide to Duran. As Indris breaks that up. But Duran right back on the ball.
She's a pretty physical player, but
yeah.
Georgia College won that. Still keep possession.
This is what we saw a lot in the first half. Possession back and forth between the two teams.
A lot of interceptions, a lot of physical play.
Just like
we see number four, Yanni Brower, putting her shoulder.
We have Duran coming up on the outside. Brooke Indris stepping up, making a play there. Freshman getting some good minutes here. Oh, a nice through ball. Amadashan is on the break with a shot over the goal. Over the goal. Great ball there by Mancinelli. Amadashan just could not get control of the ball to get a good finish there on the goal.
Some good closing speed by the Clayton State defenders as well, making it difficult for her.
Yeah.
Still a decent start to the half. It's a decent chance.
Yeah. As Charman kicks it away, headed by Ferry. Into the middle, Casey Hamilton drops it back to Baldassini. Out wide to Brooke Indris. Baldassini in the middle. Millie York. Will she get to it? Yes, she will.
I think Indris has played pretty well.
Yeah.
After coming in at halftime.
It'll be a Bobcat throw in. Schwartz over here on the front side of your screen. Into Amishon, wide open. Who's called for an unfortunate handball? Number four, Brower, with a free kick up to Bardis. Bardis maintains possession out wide to number 13, Sela. To number 15, Bacorizo. Bardis again in the middle. Brooke Indris with the clearance to Anne Michon. Amanda Ferry has a lot of room up to Maddie Steven. She will not get there.
Slightly overhit there, but that was a good thought there.
Yeah.
Trying to push the pace a little bit.
Millie York with the big clearance for the Bobcats there. Bardis with some fancy footwork. Not working out.
Tackled by Casey Hamilton. Hamilton wasn't having any of that.
Win it! Ooh. Ah. Maddie Steven just had their momentum going the wrong way. She steamed up, get to this ball. She does. Some good defense there by Clayton State. Way to keep possession of that ball. Keeping it away from Maddie Steven as Schwartz blocks out number 15, Bacorizo, for a Bobcat throw-in. Casey Hamilton with an unfortunate pass there. Giving up possession. Back to number 5.
Jasmine Miettinen.
Jasmine Miettinen.
From Finland.
From Finland. All these foreign names are getting me. As Graham punts it away. As Duran plays it back. And into the middle to Gillespie. It's a cross that'll go wide left. And Schwartz doesn't like the look of that and plays it out of bounds. Cross blocked by Schwartz. Millie York with the clearance. Another shot, but Ashley Graham lets that one go as it goes wide left of the goal.
She had that one covered.
Yeah. Yep. Just under 32 minutes here left in the second half of Clayton State and Georgia College. It is tied 1-1.
Bobcats have had 3 shots this half, Clayton State. Just that one that we just saw.
Yeah. As the ball goes over the fence for another goal kick for Ashley Graham.
Feel sorry for the poor guy who has to go get that. Hop in the fence.
And here goes Graham. Right before midfield, headed to Bacquarizo as she tries to play it into the middle, but Schwartz is there. And Maddie Steven looking to make a move on the outside here. And she does, gets around a defender. And Megs another, and stays with it. But is dispossessed, and it will be a throw-in.
Yanne Brower there, forced to just try to get the ball out.
Yeah.
Maddie Steven was wrecking havoc over there.
Schwartz with a throw-in for Georgia College. It goes to Ferry on the... Oh, wow. An unfortunate goal kick there. David, it is 92 degrees outside, and it feels like 98.
It's Middle Georgia.
Middle Georgia, baby. Those girls have drank a lot of water.
Hopefully.
As Schwartz plays some defense here.
Bacquarizo again. Probably one of the more dangerous players on the pitch today.
Yeah. Bartis to Gillespie. Gillespie out wide.
Bacquarizo seems to have shaken off that little injury she picked up in the first half.
Yeah. Maddie Steven here. Back to Casey Hamilton. Back to Steven. Into the middle to Anne Michon. Dispossessed. Ferry has it now. Looking back middle to Mancinelli. But that ball is intercepted. Is now Duran with the ball. Back to Miettinen. Out wide. A little too wide for a Bobcat throw-in.
And out goes Amanda Ferry. And that is, looks to be
Sophia Lekas. Yeah.
Oh, wow. Crunching tackle there.
Crunching
by Baldessina.
I like that. Crunching.
She felt that one.
Just under, or just right at 28 minutes left here in the second half of play. Still 1-1.
Feels like a game that's going to go down to the wire.
Yeah, it does.
These teams pretty evenly matched from what we've seen.
So the ball goes in with a shot. It went wide, right? Ashley Graham was not worried about that one. We'll be watching Lekas up at the top right portion of your screen. She has a lot of speed up there for for Georgia College, hoping to get the ball up to her.
Fresh legs as well.
Yeah. Brooke Endress with another clearance. Brooke playing well for a freshman in this high-quality PBC matchup today. Back to Steven. Over. Almost to Lekas. And Michonne. Michonne with some nice footwork with a shot headed out by Brower. Now Duran with it. A foul on Anya Mancinelli. Some of the Georgia College fans disagree with that, but it's all right. Soccer. Fouls go either way. And the ball is high. Missed by Wilhelm. Cleared by York.
Well, York has been very steady at the back in this game.
In the middle now is McKevitt out wide. Intercepted by Brooke Endress. Leck is playing defense. Back to Endress. Endress taking it herself into Maddie Steven in the middle with the ball to Amishon. Amishon has it. Amishon shoots, but is blocked by number 5, Jasmine Mietinen.
Just couldn't get enough space there. That was a nice play. There's a lot of space on the this near side of the field, and she just couldn't get the shot off.
Yeah. Baldassini to Lekas. Out back to Baldassini. In to Maddie Steven. Just over the head of Steven. Now to Schwartz, as Schwartz plays it into Lekas. Lekas using her body to try to create that space to get the ball. As there's some physical play in the middle of the field.
Nothing new for this game.
You can hear him yelling about it. It's a foul on Lekas.
Ref trying to calm players down, keep control of the game.
Number 6, Gillespie, will take this free kick. I'm sorry, that was number 5, Mietinen.
Millie York again with the clearance.
And it rolls over to Graham as Graham picks it up and goes right out to Schwartz. And Amishon. Pass Amishon. Lekas tries to play it up, cleared out. Back to Schwartz. Now McKevitt in the middle of the field for Clayton State. Casey Hamilton for George College. You know, in the action. Maddie Steven.
That was a nice find as well.
Yeah.
Maddie Steven. Some pace.
As she takes it down with the cross. It's up, it's away. Lekas was there, but so was the defender. Cleared out. Clayton State, now Bardis. Bardis with some nice footwork.
That's a foul.
Casey Hamilton.
Good foul as well.
Yeah, stopped the momentum.
A lot of open field ahead of Bardis again. It's been one of the themes of the game. Clayton State coach not too happy. Letting his players and the ref hear it.
Mietinen with the free kick. It's a long one. Up to York, who clears it away. Casey Hamilton and and Bacquizzero fighting that. York now. As the cross goes in for Clayton State, a little far. Endress on Duran. As Duran tries, there's another foul as Duran grabs York. I mean, Endress. Sorry about that.
Duran has been one of the more physical players on the pitch today.
We'll see Ashley Graham come out of her goalie box here for the free kick. is there's a hold up in the action here. I think the ref is having a word with the Clayton State head coach, telling him to calm down a tinch. Graham sends it high right there, and Legis with an unfortunate handball, and she takes off again. Now in the middle with Gillespie, out wide to Duran. Indris on defense, back to Gillespie with Wilhelm on defense. In the middle, Sayla still with the ball, out wide. Shot goes wide left. Shot goes wide left. That is 9 shots for Clayton State, 7 for Georgia College. Score is still 1-1 with 21 minutes and 37 seconds left in the game.
And that's Fergal Ford, the interim head coach in his first season, head coach for the Clayton State Lakers. Definitely not liking the physical tone this game has been playing with, is being played with right now.
Yeah.
Not happy with his players either. Here's Schwartz.
Schwartz in the middle.
Oh.
The ref with a little confusion there. Called the foul first on Lekas, but then realized his mistake, and it will be a free kick about 10 yards outside of the box for Georgia College. This could be dangerous for Clayton State.
It's Baldessini there to take it.
The ref backs him up 10 yards. And be watching for a rebound here. Maybe Georgia College can put this in.
See if she tries for a shot.
I think she will. Here she goes. Stepping up. It'll just go over.
There's not enough dip on it, but decent attempt.
Be sure and join us the 28th here on the Bobcat Broadcast Network for Georgia College and UNC Pembroke as another Peach Belt Conference matchup begins.
And Clayton State played UNC Pembroke in their last game and lost 3-0, so definitely should be a good game.
Yeah. As we see Clayton State pushing up the field here, but Baldessini will have none of that as she kicks it off one of the Clayton State attackers, and it goes in.
Spacarizzo maintaining possession. Schwartz with some nice defense on the wing there.
Yeah.
But they say it's off of Schwartz, and it'll be the Clayton State Lakers ball.
Into the middle to Gibson. Cross goes in front of the bar.
Thankfully, nobody at the back post there for
yeah.
Clayton State, because it made its way all the way through.
Ball in. Schwartz stumbles on it, but somehow maintains possession. Almost snuck it through to Steven. Intercepted. Now into Gillespie. She is called offsides.
Georgia College defense, pretty lucky there.
Yeah. Well, there. As the ball has yet touched ground, there it is. We have Mancinelli there to Amishon. And Amishon into Lekas. Lekas plays it in Amishon, but is cleared out.
Tries to do the 1-2 there.
Yeah.
But Clayton State defense plays it well.
up to Steven. Steven over to Lekas. Just too much juice on that one. Charman will come up and scoop that one up.
Charman's goal kicks in this game have not been very high, nor handsome.
Into the middle now. Baldassini will clear it out of there. Kind of a frustration clearance.
Amanda Bartholomew in for the Bobcats for Raleigh Onimashaw. And that is Tovin Saleh out and Marie Durr in. Well, that's her first, it's going to be her first action in the game with about 16 minutes and 30 seconds left to go.
Clayton State throws it in. Into Bartis. Bartis makes a move on Mancinelli. Cleared out. Played back out to Durr as she gets her first touch of the game. Durr. Long cross in. Graham is there. Graham rolls it out to Elise Schwartz on the right side. Schwartz with a ball way up there. Looking for Lekas as Lekas was fouled.
That's Mietinen going over the back there.
This will be Baldassini again with her left foot trying to send it in here to the box. Maybe the Bobcats will put one in here. Puts her hand up. She starts approaching the ball. Kick is away. Up high. Headed out. Kicked out. York there.
Nice.
York with a nice touch. And a nice ball to Bartholomew as the foul is called against Bartholomew, which is...
Or maybe she was offside.
Maybe. And that ball was not stopped. So it must be stopped before you can play, says the soccer rule book. Still not stopped, but all right. Play goes on. For Brower, plays it forward. York is there.
Again.
Indris over the top, into the middle to Steven. Steven does not get there. Now Durr takes it up the field as she plays it forward to Gillespie. And Wilhelm is there to clear it out for a corner.
Skylar Young. Skylar Young into the game. First action.
I'm sorry, that was not a corner. It was a throw-in. Cleared out by Baldassini. Immediately put back in. Skylar Young on the ball. Out the Durr, cleared out. Oh, put in the middle by York. Number 19, as it will go off to the right now for a corner. That'll be the fifth corner of the game for Clayton State to Georgia College's one. Duran will take it. As their kick is off. Ball is headed. She Ooh. Tries to bike it. Ashley Graham is there.
That would have been some goal.
That would have been an awesome goal. And Bartholomew is there.
Oh.
Bartholomew on a breakaway. She has Lekas out wide. She's still there. She's still there.
What
saved.
A save.
Saved by Charman. Wow.
Sharman has made two saves this whole game, and both have been spectacular. Some really great closing speed there by Durr to close down Bartholomew.
Bartholomew with some momentum now as she plays it back to Baldassini. Out to Indris. The freshman doing some work out there.
Bobcats are showing some drive here, trying to get to that go-ahead goal with just 12 minutes left to go here in the game.
Out wide to Lekas. Lekas with a turn. Cannot get around Durr, but it will be a throw-in for Schwartz. Throws right into Bartholomew as Bartholomew crosses, but it will go behind the goal for a goal kick. We have Uno over there on the sidelines warming up for Georgia College. Might see an appearance from her pretty soon. As the goal kick goes away, headed by Baldassini, strong. Mancinelli with a high kick into the middle. Back to Mancinelli, out to Lekas. Lekas up to Schwartz. Schwartz out wide. Bad touch. As Durr comes over to take the throw in for Clayton State. Ball goes into the middle. Back out wide again. York is there with a soft clearance. Still got to Schwartz, but Schwartz with a tackle. Gillespie. As the advantage is played for Clayton State and the foul will be called. It will be a free kick for Clayton State. About 20 yards outside the box. 25 yards outside the box, probably. Duran takes her steps back. Kick is away.
Ooh,
that was nice.
Connection on the header, but wide. And here is Oon coming in for Lekas.
Uno, dos, tres. Yeah, that was weird. Mancinelli up to Bartholomew. Bartholomew looking, playing forward. A little physical play there, looking for Steven up top, as well as in. Sharman will take this kick right up to midfield. Won by Uno. She is dispossessed. Brooke Indris there with some nice play. It'll have to go back to Graham. As the ball will roll out for a Georgia College throw-in. And the ball will be taken back by Clayton State's back line. Up in the middle. Now up top to Skylar Young, but cleared out by Millie York.
We have another substitution on the way. Aida Tapia in for Alexis Gibson.
Now for all you Georgia fans out there, Georgia Bulldogs, that is, Nick Chubb has suffered a sprained ankle. So, not good for the Bulldogs. Just a little snippet of college football information for you. As it will be a Clayton State throw-in.
Well, technically, we are watching college football.
College football.
College football.
F-U-T. Bartholomew gains possession of the ball.
Looking to push the pace with Oon.
Right back. Ah.
Good interception there by number five, Jasmine Miettinen.
15, Bacquarizo pushing the ball up forward. Schwartz is there. Centered in. Down goes Baldassini. Uh-oh. Ball in.
Oh. Oh. Wow.
It's a goal by Clayton State into the bottom right-hand corner of the goal. Just unfortunate for the Bobcats as it squeaked through.
And that is Maria Bartis again. She has two now in this game. Just snuck through the defense there and tucked it away. Bobcats have 6 minutes, 44 seconds left to try to get an equalizer here.
Over to Casey Hamilton, out to Schwartz. Now played way up forward to Oon, trying to get there. Diving stop by Sharman.
We're going to see a lot of that as the Bobcats try to push forward quickly.
Punted forward, won by Mancinelli. Out to Maddie Steven. Can she get there? No, she will be beaten by Durr. Schwartz outside to Bartholomew. Bartholomew.
Oh, wow.
With a hard foul.
That might be a yellow card.
On Bartis.
Ref keeps his cards in his pocket, but that was definitely a pretty bad foul there.
With Baldassini looking to take the free kick as she kisses the ball. Maybe we'll see a goal here. Bobcats crowding the middle left side of the box as Millie York in the back, maybe looking for a header. Baldassini raises her hand. Bobcat, stopped by Sharman. There's a little outside to the left of the goal. You can feel the intensity picking up in the game as Georgia College realizes they have to put some pressure on this back line. Indris with a throw-in into Mancinelli. Back to Baldassini. With a long run that will go out. Fletcher could not get there. Oon with the ball now, making her way up the sidelines, dispossessed.
Inside of 5 minutes here, Bobcats need to get the ball in the opposing half.
Cleared out by Wilhelm. Back to Durr. With another shot blocked by Wilhelm's head.
It's an ambitious effort.
Graham with a punt, long one, right to midfield, right to Bartholomew. As she tries to play it up to Oon. Oon's coming. Will she get there? I don't think she will.
She may be small, but she has a lot of energy.
She does. And Bartholomew back with the ball.
We need to get some more people forward here.
Yeah.
Give them some support.
Baldassini with a nice move in the middle. Looking forward to Uno, as Uno is stuffed.
What a play by Guernsey there. Keep the ball in.
Now Fletcher has it as she plays it way forward. Wilhelm is there with the stop. Now Baldassini in the middle. Just under 4 minutes left here, left in the game. as Clayton State leads George College 2-1. Schwartz pressing.
Some bit of miscommunication there.
Millie York now. And the ball will go off there for a Bobcat throw-in. Be a substitution now.
Bringing on Raleigh at Anamashan. And they're taking off Oon.
Oh.
Definitely need to hurry up here. Don't have much time to work with. Clock ticking down.
Just under 2 minutes, 45 seconds now. Up to Bartholomew. Played back to Schwartz. Schwartz plays it in. Amishon is there, just squeaked over the head of her. Amishon still on the ball. Back to Schwartz. Ball goes back in. Mancinelli's there. Cleared out by Clayton State.
Questionable defense there, letting the ball bounce in the box, but Georgia College could not capitalize. And now they're counterattacking. Bakariz with a lot of pace on the left side.
York with nice defense as she plays it off. Caparizo for a Bobcat throw in. Just under 2 minutes now left in the game. Bartholomew gains possession of the ball, loses it. Bartis has the ball now. Bouncing back and forth between teams as York tries to play the ball out, and she gets it to Schwartz. Schwartz out of bounds. Bobcat throw in. Bartholomew headed up, flicked to Mancinelli. Mancinelli with a bad ball into the middle.
Not out. Enough support here up front.
No. Out it's wide.
It's now or never.
With a minute 14 left to go, out wide to Sol Baldassini. Baldassini looking, serving the field into the middle, headed out. Clayton State now with the ball out wide. Just under a minute now. Millie York back to Schwartz. Schwartz with a bad touch. And you
and the Bobcats right there.
And the clock will stop for a substitution. Out goes number 8, Ayanna Tapio. In comes number 19, Alexis Gibson. Clock should start back up now. Yep. Oh, here we go.
Oh, wow.
Here we go. Is this Maddie Steven? Maddie Steven! Maddie Steven! What? Misses on far right. Misses right.
Oh, wow. What a chance for Steven right there to tie up the game.
Oh, my goodness. That would have been it.
And Charmin will just let the clock tick down as far as she can.
22 seconds left now.
That was the best chance that the Bobcats could have asked for in that situation, but... some confusion here.
20 seconds put back on the clock. Charmin boots it away. Schwartz needs to send it way back. Bartholomew. And that might just do it for the Bobcats here as Charmin grabs it, and that will be the game here today. With a nice Peach Belt Conference matchup. Unfortunately, the Bobcats could not pull it out today as Clayton State wins 2-1. And Bobcats move to 1-2 in the Peach Belt. And let's see, and 3-2-1 overall. And Clayton State moves to 5-2 overall and a 2-1 in the Peach Belt. This is Riley Williams here for David Paulson on the Bobcat Broadcast Network. Thank you for joining us, and join us the 28th to watch your Bobcats back in action. Thank you, guys. Have a great day.